This is the day the Lord has made, so let us rejoice and be glad in it. I am Pastor Marianne Kallenbach, pastor at Living Faith Church, which is located in the community of Tradition in the city of Port St. Lucie in Florida. And today is Monday, August the 16th in the year 2021. It's a tough morning. You turn on the news and your heart breaks. Over and over and over. The number of COVID cases are increasing in our country, as well as the rest of the world with the Delta variant. And we had watched on television the fall of the city Kabul. And that is reminiscent for many of us of the fall of Saigon. And just to watch the people who are in fear of their lives. And so this morning, our devotion from Jesus Always, Sarah Young, we question, you know, what is it that we can do? And here is Jesus speaking to us on this. Never underestimate the power of prayer. People who are feeling discouraged and hopeless often say something like, there's nothing left to do but pray. There's nothing left to do but pray. The implication is that this is their last resort, and a feeble one at that. Nothing could be further from the truth. I created mankind with the ability to communicate with me. Since I am the eternal, immortal, invincible King of the universe, this is an astounding and astonishing privilege. Even when the human race became tainted with sin through Adam and Eve's disobedience, I did not withdraw this glorious privilege. And when I lived in your world as a flesh and blood man, I relied heavily on praying to my Father. I was keenly aware of how continuously I need his help. Persistent, heartfelt prayer will bless not only you, but also your family, your friends, your church, your country, and even the world. Ask the Holy Spirit to help you pray effectively. Find others to join you in this venture of seeking my face in humility and repentance. Beseech me to heal your land. Perfect, perfect for this morning. I remember early on, I had said to somebody, it was many years ago, well, we can just pray. And I remember this woman saying to me, no, 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 remove the just. It's not that we can just pray. She said, we pray. That's the privilege that we have been given, that we can go before the creator of the universe and pray and ask and intercede on the behalf of another. And that's what we do this morning. Let us pray. Good and gracious Lord God, yes, we live in a fallen world. We give thanks to your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Lord and our Savior, who, because you understand exactly who we are and what we are capable of doing and capable of not doing, not capable of doing is really the words, we thank you that you have come to reconcile with us, doing and accomplishing something that we could not do. We come to you in prayer this morning, gracious Lord God, and we ask and beg of you to be with all of your children throughout the world. Heal them, give them wholeness, give them comfort, give them strength, give them courage, give them boldness. Mostly, give them peace. Envelop them in your light of love. Embrace them and let them know that they are not alone. We ask that you soften the hardened hearts of your children who seek to destroy, to conquer, and to enslave and oppress. Loosen their hearts. Make your presence aware to them. Gracious Lord God, pour your Holy Spirit into the hearts of those who are hurting now. Let them be filled with your presence and know that they are not alone, and that there is a world who is indeed praying for them. We ask all of this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now we pray those words that our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. On this 16th day in the year 2021, in the month of August, I beseech upon you to pray for all of humankind at this time. And now go and do your fitness part of today to keep your bodies healthy, your physical bodies healthy and strong. Blessings, and I'll see you tomorrow.